The revelation was made by Isaac Wani, Director of Network Planning and Engineering at UNRWA, while appearing before Parliament's Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises, COSASE, where the authority was responding to queries raised in the December 2023 Auditor General's report. Committee members tasked UNRWA to explain that formula that was used to arrive at the fixed road toll charges levied against road users starting from 5,000 shillings for small cars.
The nice one about the public, this collection of road toll, it's going to take for how long? Because Ugandans have to be aware that they are contributing this for a certain period of time, or at a given time, money would be reduced for that load specifically.
Or even if we continue paying, we should know that we are just contributing to the development of our country, and that part of the money is not going out.
Will the toll collection be taking? We will continue collecting tolls for the foreseeable future, not just to pay back the loan, but as a form of revenue generation. As to the quantum of the toll, I will invite Engineer Wani to speak on how it was set up, why the 5,000, and why not more, why not less.
So how we came up with this rate is out of a study. We carry out what we call willingness to pay. We do traffic counts on along the road and the adjacent roads. We determine how many vehicles will use the road if there is no payment. And then we carry out a questionnaire for people to determine what they will be happy to pay.
In December, UNRWA revealed that it had generated 75 billion shillings revenue from road toll fees at Kampala Entebbe Expressway, with 40 billion shillings collected in 2023 alone. But documents before COSASE indicate that only 27 billion shillings was remitted to the consolidated fund as revenue from Entebbe Expressway. Members of Parliament questioned the expenditure.
How much do we collect? How much do we take as our percentage, and how much does the Exim Bank take, based on what formula?
COSASE also tasked UNRWA to explain the logic behind the closing of the Entebbe Expressway whenever President Museveni is using the road.
When the president, I don't want to use the words used by some people, is in his bathroom in Entebbe, but when the president is about to, thinks of leaving Entebbe to Kampala, you close the road. You mean you have no mechanism of knowing when to close the road? I understand.
Yes, I think it's a good proposal about restricting exit. We shall look at that with our design team. What we are doing actually on the Northern Bypass now, we have a periodic maintenance contract. We are going to give some exits.
Meanwhile, the Parliament's Public Accounts Committee has tasked the Permanent Secretary of the Office of the Prime Minister to cause appearance of the former accounting officers of the entity on Friday to account for audit queries which were committed during their time, especially issues to do with iron sheets.
There are many things that have happened in the Office of the Prime Minister that in the year under review we have had two or three accounting officers.
Are they all here?
No, two of them are on interdiction, and I have one here who was only there for a few days to the close of the financial year. But I take a responsibility. You see, when you take over office, you take over assets and liabilities, and I am willing, Honorable Chair.
So one cannot use interdiction as a failure or a ground. And accounting officer, I don't want you to risk to carry a cross that does not belong to you.
Please, do a nice job. Make our work. This is also making you look ugly. You already bad. The entity, not you, the entity is already looking terrible, shabby in the eyes of them. And the issues here might, by the way, members have gone through their or your report. We've had a briefing, which I'm going to recall.
The committee is, among others, expected to probe into the iron sheets saga, irregularities around their staff and how their salaries were made during the year under review. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.